Extraordinary is a choice. When you think about people of faith that give or have given extraordinarily, who do you think about? I'm sure you have a short list of names in your head. Maybe some of that list inspire your faith walk. When we think about living extraordinarily in our faith, we usually think about evangelizing or outreach or mission work or giving grand amounts of financial support to a good cause. It may very well be that you are called to these things, but allow me to present the possibility that there are other opportunities.
There are other opportunities.
Where are you in life? Who are you? What are the gifts that you possess that can be used in service to God? You have been created by a God who has no equal. The concept of ordinary and extraordinary are of man. We were made for service to God.
We were made for service to God.
It is embedded in our hearts as part of who and what we are. What would happen if we chose to let that part of our creation out? Let's take Mother Teresa as an example. I'm sure many of us had her on our short list of those that inspire us. Many of us see her work in Calcutta as extraordinary and inspirational. Many saw her as an example of what it means to go into the world to be the hands of Christ, to do His work for the sake of reaching the lost. Now you may be saying, well, I'm no Mother Teresa and I'm not about to move to India. You're right, you're not. But you are the you that God created in a very special way. The same eternal, majestic, and holy fingerprints that were left on the heart of Mother Teresa at her creation are the same as the ones left on yours when you were formed. This means that we have a choice. The choice is to decide between ordinary and extraordinary as it is defined by our earthly existence. Ordinary is what many would see as normal, acceptable, and expected from a human perspective. Ordinary can't be viewed as the norm. It has to be viewed as the exact polar opposite of extraordinary. This makes ordinary a choice just as extraordinary is. Even in the act of not deciding to choose one or the other, we choose to be ordinary because extraordinary requires action and intent, which in many cases is the opposite of ordinary. What is your choice?